Hello, this is Carlos Almeida from SPK and Associates. Today we're going to talk about the PTC Codebeamer Jira integration. We're going to take a quick look. The Jira integration comes out of the box. There is no extra software required. It works for both Jira Server and for Jira Cloud as of version 9.4. Jira data can be imported into Codebeamer. Codebeamer can be exported out into Jira, or you can set it up to be bi-directional. It is a very robust system with the capability of mapping just about any Jira field, and it is very easy to configure. Let's start with the Jira side. I've created a simple project in Jira called Codebeamer Jira Demo. It is a software project, and I've created four bug issue types inside the project, bug 1 through 4. Let's go over to the Codebeamer side. I've created a simple project called Jira Sync Demo. Examine our trackers. I'm going to check out the bugs tracker type. At this point, I do not have any bugs created. So let us run a synchronize with Jira command. And since this is the first time we're running a synchronization, you're going to see this pop up. Let's click on yes. This reveals the configuration panel. I already have my cloud IP address here and my username. The password, since I'm using the cloud configuration, is actually a Jira API token, which I created in advance. So I'm going to insert that now. As soon as I do that, I now see all of my Jira projects on my cloud site. I'm going to click on the Codebeamer Jira demo project that I created. There are four issue types in this project. I'm going to select the bug issue type, and then I'm going to click preview. It takes me right back into my Jira screen so I can see indeed I'm actually covering those four bugs. Now let's click OK and begin working on our field mappings. The first thing I'm going to do is set the direction. I would like this to be a bi-directional synchronization. Next, I'm going to select users so I can leverage the assigned user field on the Jira side. I do have the option to bring in groups as well. And versions are often most tied to the Jira software releases. And you have the option for components, teams, and epic links as well. Now I'm going to map the status field. And these are correct. Let's take a look at the priority field. I see that most of them are correct, but I'm going to have to create or map three different fields which are not there. Codebeamer has the capability of creating these on the fly. So if I click on New, and it already populates the field that I want, and I say OK. Similarly, I'm going to do this for Medium. And for Informational. And I have links as well if I wanted to take advantage of that. And I'm going to set an interval for synchronization, let's say every 10 minutes. Over here, I could save this as a configuration so I can reuse this mapping for other projects if I want to. And I could load them in if I had that file. So I'm going to click OK. Here you can see that I have my synchronization window up. I have not ever done it, so this is the first time. And I will actually initialize my first synchronization when I click Synchronize. And I'm presented with a summary table showing that four items were created. And the Codebeamer bug tracker is brought up again. And you can see that the four Jira items were brought into my Jira Sync demo project. Now that we have our Jira bugs inside Codebeamer, let's make a change on the Codebeamer side and have it reflected in the Jira project. So I'm going to change the priority of this to informational. And then I'm going to synchronize. It would do it automatically, but I don't want to wait the 10 minutes. It shows me that I have one already done earlier today, and the next one is scheduled for that, and I have history, but let's synchronize. There is the item that was updated. So we go over to Jira project and refresh it. The priority field for this bug issue type is now in sync with Codebeamer. It's listed as informational. Okay, just one more thing I'd like to show you. Let's go back into the Codebeamer application and hit synchronize again. This time I want to dig into the history a little bit more. Codebeamer maintains good information about the history of your updates. This is the initial one when we loaded four issue types in. And here is the updated one that I just did. It's dynamic, so you click on it, you can see that I changed the priority field to informational.